Alright guys, Liz Stapleton here from bloggerbreakthrough.com, and in this video I'm going to just show you around ClickUp, which is my favorite tool to sort of manage all my online business stuff as well as some personal things. So I'm going to show you how I use it, sort of what the hierarchy is. I did write a post about why I think ClickUp is the best project management tool for bloggers. The link to that is going to be in the description below if you want to check that out. But let's go ahead and dive in.
So this is my ClickUp. I'm in my everything. So within ClickUp, you have a workspace. So this is my elizabethstapleton.com workspace. And I can always jump to other ones. So you can see here's my workspace, and then here's just like a life one that I made up to play around with stuff. And then within your workspace, you have spaces. So I've got one for each website. I've got one for team, and this is where we go over, you know, our systems and processes, mission, and the various roles. And then you can see these have little locks by them. They're private. I don't want my team necessarily seeing them, particularly the personal. They don't need to know, and I'm giving my dog her heart guard. But that's the kind of reminders that I have in there so that I just, you know, just because otherwise I forget. And then operations as well, which there's some client management things there. So it just shows everything. So I've got a bunch of stuff that's overdue. I have stuff I need to get done today and tomorrow. And I can always go in and adjust these. And if I want to just look at, okay, what do I got going on for bloggerbreakthrough.com? I can go in here and just look at the tasks for there. And I've got within spaces, you can have both folders and lists. So you see, I've got lots of folders here. I've got a content folder where I've got blog posts, guest posts, podcasts, you know, and you can see the number of tasks in each. So this is, you know, and then within the folders are lists. So lists can exist within folders, but they don't have to. They can also exist just on their own. So I've got that going on. And then, you know, I can see here's blog posts that are outlined, what I need to do. I can also group by different statuses, by, you know, the due date. So rather than having all the blog posts together, I see everything. So some of these are YouTube, some of these are the podcast. This is YouTube. Let's go ahead and open it up. You can see it says YouTube. It says scheduled. I've got what's left to do, and I can actually see what I'd already completed. Okay. And so these are subtasks, and you can also do checklists. The difference between the two is subtasks allow you to assign due dates. You can also assign people to them. So these are all assigned to me, although my VA usually does the transcription stuff. She's on vacation. So, and then your subtasks can have subtasks. So I like having all these different subtasks in because it just makes sure I don't miss a step. And then you do checklists, but you can also use a template. And this is true for the subtasks too. So I can go up here and I can go to my template center. And I can browse a template to apply it. So there's a lot of things you can do. There's no way I can cover everything within ClickUp, but I just want to show you a couple things. And then these are all related tasks. And the reason I relate them is because I batch create. So I made this video in the same sort of batched it with these other videos. So these other tasks. You can have attachments, you can have comments and notes. So there's a lot you can do with a task. One of my favorite things, because let me just go into blog posts. One of my favorite things is the automations within ClickUp. And I'm on a paid plan, but you get automations on the free plan too. Because all blog posts, while the topic changes, the process is the same. I've got to do the keyword research. I need to outline the post. It needs to be drafted or sent over to, you know, freelance writer. It needs to be edited. If I'm making a video, there's a lot of steps to that. You know, all that is the same. So what I did is I created, once you create a task, you can save it as a template. So once I created my template for blog posts, I set up an automation. So let's go here. So that anytime I add a task to this list, it automatically applies the template. So I don't have to go in every time and do that, which is really quite nice because it makes sure everything gets done, right? And it can even sort of adjust the due dates if you have due dates in the template and stuff too, so that they're relative to the due date of the new post. So that is my favorite automation by far. Just, it makes life easy. It makes sure I don't miss anything. And then of course there's task statuses. So you can create custom statuses. So I like doing like little fun things, like that. And this is also, you can customize what you're viewing, right? So if you want to view, because you can do custom, like here we go. So within my blog post, you may have seen that I have custom fields. So the Canva graphics link, the draft link, the HubScript URL. So if you want to see, like, if I want to add the post URL view here, I could. And I could save this view if I want to. Okay, but I like having the publish date. I actually don't really want that. So my due date and my publish date are different. Ideally, I'm done with the blog post and it's scheduled, rather than, you know, having to, like, finish it on the fly. So my due date and my publish date are different, and my publish date is a custom field that I have in there. And I also like to see the progress, the estimated amount of time. Because of the tasks in there, I have the time estimate. It all of them will say 6 hours and 45 minutes. Some take way longer. It just kind of depends on the content I'm creating, but it always gives me a good idea. Same with the podcast. So that's just kind of how I like to use it. I'm going to show you around just a couple other things you could do. You can prioritize things, right? So you can set a priority. You can also set an automation. Like if the due date's getting close and you want the priority to be bumped up, you can. And then docs. So if you really like kind of working all in one place, then ClickUp's great because it allows you to do docs. And you can import or export them, which is quite nice. So I can just hit add a new document, and it really got all the functionality of Google Docs for the most part. Title it, you can add URLs, there's all the different functionality. You won't have this. This is part of something else I have installed on my computer. You can have it pinned, or unpinned rather. So yeah, you can add an icon. There's all sorts of different things you can do. So if I go, I'm going to actually delete this. I'm going to show you one of my other documents. But so this could be a blog post, right? I keep my SOPs in here. And so these are all the June 2021 scripts. That's what I'm working on right now. but within this SOP, I've got sub pages, right? So how I create a podcast episode, you know, my affiliate program, customer support answers. And I those have sub documents as well. Right? So that's like a script template, but I can click on this and it'll pull up, you know, sort of all the steps to creating a podcast episode. So it's a great tool. I share it with my VA, so she's able to see everything, and it just keeps everything nice and neat in one place. I like adding the little emojis because I think it's just fun and it makes it easier to figure out what you want to grab. Because again, our brains process images much faster than they do text. So let me just see. Oh, and the final thing I wanted to show you guys is the notepad. So this is, if you're not ready to create a task yet, you're just kind of thinking through something, you can create a notepad, right? And you can just write down your notes. This is great for courses you're taking. If you have an action item based on that or a meeting or something along those lines, you can do that. And then if you decide you need to take it and turn it into a task, you can just highlight it and hit new task, which is pretty cool. So that is the notepad. I hope you found that helpful. I hope you guys found this video helpful. I think you should totally use ClickUp if you are a blogger. It kind of keeps it all nice and neat and clean. You can create dashboards and other views, but I almost always just use my everything sort of space, and then I'll maybe bust out subtasks that I need to get done too. But yeah, so that's ClickUp for you. It's free. The link to it is in my description. I am an affiliate because I love and use it, as you can see. Guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have questions, let me know in the comments.